40%, and 70% isopropyl alcohol. How do these solutions differ in terms of their quantitative concentrations? Hello, Saipals! I am Ma'am Senny Moreno, your science teacher for today. In this episode of Agham Alam Hub, we're going to express concentrations of solutions quantitatively. We will calculate the percent by volume and percent by mass of concentrations using available solutions at home. Moreover, we will demonstrate how to prepare solutions with different concentrations. In the next few minutes, we will explore science for another moment. Remember that solutions are made up of solute and solvent. In a solution, solute is the substance being dissolved, while solvent is the substance that dissolves the solute. Common examples of solutions at home include vinegar, which consists of 4% acetic acid, isopropyl rubbing alcohol, which has 40% or 70% concentration, and 0.9% normal saline solution, which contains salt and water and is used to clean wounds, clear sinuses, and treat dehydration. What do 4%, 0.9%, 40%, and 70% concentrations mean? Concentration is the amount of dissolved solute in a given amount of solvent in a solution. Concentrations of solutions can be expressed in two ways: percent by volume and percent by mass. Percent by volume is the ratio of the volume of solute to the sum of the volume of solute and solvent multiplied by 100. Percent by mass is the ratio of the mass of solute to the sum of mass of solute and solvent multiplied by 100. Let us show how to calculate concentrations in terms of percent by volume and percent by mass. What is the percent by volume of vinegar if the solution contains 4 milliliters of acetic acid and 96 milliliters of water, which is the solute and the solvent in our problem? Right! Acetic acid is the solute and water is the solvent. Let us refer to the formula of percent by volume so we can calculate its value. To calculate the percent by volume, we must divide the volume of solute by the sum of the volume of solute and solvent and multiply the quotient by 100. In the given problem, since 4 milliliters of acetic acid is our solute and 96 milliliters of water is our solvent, the total volume of solution is 100 milliliters. Using the formula, we divide 4 milliliters by 100 milliliters to get the quotient, which is 0.04. We multiply this value with 100 to get the final answer. This means that the concentration of the vinegar solution is 4%. It also means that every 100 milliliters of vinegar contains 4 milliliters of acetic acid. In the case of 70% rubbing alcohol, what is the volume of isopropyl alcohol present in the solution? That's right! It contains 70 milliliters isopropyl alcohol for every 100 milliliters of rubbing alcohol. This mixture is effectively used as disinfectant to prevent the spread of bacteria and viruses. Coconut wine or lambanog is a local product of Tayabas City in Quezon Province, which has alcohol concentration of 40 to 45%. Let us now solve a problem on percent by mass. What is the percent by mass of normal saline solution if it contains 0.90 grams of salt dissolved in 99.10 milliliters of water? Which is the solute and the solvent in our problem? Right! Salt is the solute and water is the solvent. Since our solvent is expressed in volume, we have to convert first the unit into mass. 1 ml is equal to 1 gram, which means that 99.10 milliliters of water is equal to 99.10 grams of water. Let us refer to the formula of percent by mass so we can calculate its value. To calculate the percent by mass, we must divide the mass of solute by the sum of the mass of solute and solvent and multiply the quotient by 100. In the given problem, since 0.90 grams of salt is our solute and 99.10 grams of water is our solvent, the total mass of the solution is 100 grams. Using the formula, we divide 0.90 grams by 100 grams to get the quotient, which is 0.009. We multiply this value with 100 to get the final answer. This means that the concentration of the normal saline solution is 0.9%. It also means that every 100 milliliter of normal saline solution contains 0.9 grams of salt. One example of a material with percent by mass concentration is sterling silver, which is used in making jewelries and kitchenwares. It is a mixture which contains 92.5% silver and 7.5% copper or other metals. This kind of combination of metals is known as an alloy. Now, let's prepare solutions based on the concentrations in the previous problems. Take note that in measuring volume of liquids, we have to use graduated cylinder. The measurement of the volume of water is read at its lower meniscus. In preparing 4% vinegar, we will measure 96 milliliters water and 4 milliliters acetic acid using graduated cylinder. We then combine these liquids to make 100 milliliter solution of 4% vinegar. On the other hand, we use digital weighing scale to get the mass of substances. Don't forget that in using the digital weighing scale, we have to get the initial mass of the container, then click the tear button before adding the substance to be measured. In preparing 0.9% normal saline solution, we will measure 0.9 grams salt and 99.10 grams of water using digital weighing scale. We then dissolve the measured salt in the water to make 100 milliliters of 0.9% normal saline solution. In this episode of Agham Alamhab, we express concentrations of solutions quantitatively. We learned that a solution is composed of solute and solvent. In a solution, solute is the substance being dissolved, while solvent is the substance that dissolves the solute. Concentration is the amount of dissolved solute in a given amount of solvent in a solution. Concentrations of solutions can be expressed quantitatively in two ways, percent by mass and percent by volume. To calculate the percent by volume, divide the volume of solute by the sum of the volume of solute and solvent and multiply the quotient by 100. To calculate the percent by mass, divide the mass of solute by the sum of the mass of solute and solvent and multiply the quotient by 100. In preparing specific concentrations of solutions, proper measurement of the amount of solute and solvent must be considered. We have to use the right equipment such as graduated cylinder and digital weighing scale in measuring volume and mass respectively. That's all for today, SciPals! Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. See you again next week for another moment! Only here in Agham Alamhab, Palajan SciTech Portal. Bye!